using Mr. Gardner, who did soft seed, to teach us how to hook up this manufacturing industry so we can be manufacturing our own products, our own new products, our own inventions. I mean, this is where we get thousands of jobs, not 100 jobs. Now, you know, Francine, we've been working with the contractors and developers in this city for over 25 years, and they're still giving us these doggone apprenticeship programs. And one of these brothers who's 50 years old today ever went from apprentice to journeyman to master, yet. So that's a joke and it's a game. And let's stop knocking our head against that brick wall. What we need to be thinking about is if we're gonna create manufacturing, then we do worker cooperatives. Because worker cooperatives, those workers own a piece of the pie, and which means that they're invested in it from beginning to end, and we don't have to ask the union to do anything. I mean, if we're going to do this, we got to be thoughtful, we got to be smart, we got to be specific, and we got to plan together and use all our educated people that are getting paid hundreds of thousands of dollars by white folks and everybody else to do things for them, bring them back into our community. Let's meet with them. Let's put them at the table. Let's get these projects together. I mean, what I'm doing on 51st Street, we started the 51st Street Business Association. I only got the King Drive to the Dale Ride specifically. I wanted to take this little 7-block area and try to see how we can turn a devastated urban environment into something positive again, okay? And it's a struggle. It's a job. But we're working, naturally, we're working with all groups on that strip, black, white, Grenadians, whatever, because they still vested too, been there 30, 40 years, to try to make a difference in showing how we can create new types of businesses that takes us into the 21st century. But you see, at the same time, right down on 51st Street on the Federal Strip, crazy where the high rises were, there's an industrial corridor there. And you know what's gonna happen? What's the train company that's coming in, North, Southern, whatever. They're gonna end up taking all those industrial areas. We got a full industrial corridor in Woodlawn from 63rd all the way down that strip on South Chicago. Those buildings been standing there, those people been trying to sell those buildings forever. Why are we not doing manufacturing on that strip? Thousands of jobs, we're not talking about hundreds of jobs. And we can't always just start, you know, I agree with your husband on this, I'm sorry. We don't need to bring Olive Garden in. Let's create our own dog on Olive Garden. We got the know-how. Because we've been taught. You got the property, we got the know-how. We've been taught by the same folks that run all these companies that, oh, well, you know, you bring us in as a franchise and, you know, we can help you make money, you can make a business. But they end up owning franchises in all our community. Where are Olive Gardens? Where are our showbiz pieces? It's not that we can't do it. It's easier to bring somebody else in and start to create your own, but we got models. We got business investment people. We gotta stop playing this game. I've been doing this work for 30 years and I'm tired now. Y'all got to get it together. Use what we have. We're smart, we're bright, we got the money. Now let's put this all together and make it.